Hello everyone, it's Lindsay, and today I'm sharing with you the newest Faith Art Box from Creative Retreat Kits. This is the Faith Art Box for the month of November, Seek First. And a little side note, I'm gonna be honest with you guys, I'm gonna try to get through this video without becoming a complete sobbing mess. I can't even tell you how much this kit has spoke to me and just the timing and everything going on, and so I'm already failing, guys. So, as part of the creative team, we get these kits a little bit early so that we have time to work with them and play with them and do the things that we need to do. And so this kit has been sitting on my desk for a few weeks now, and I've just been so busy, and I kept looking at it, meaning to sit down with it and look at it, and I just kept putting it aside and putting it aside and putting it aside. And so I sat down right now, looked at it before I do this video. I'm filming this just a couple days before the first, when you guys are going to be seeing this, and it's like God knew exactly the timing that I needed to see this kit and read what Danielle has in her devotional content. So I just feel like this kit was specifically made for me, and I know that that's not the case. And so I really think that this is going to speak to many of you. And so I want to talk about the stamp set for a second, because this is what kind of started it as being personal for me. So a few months ago, Danielle from the creative team, she kind of bounces ideas off of us sometimes and asks our input about certain things and design elements. And so she was asking about the stamp set. And so I special requested this really adorable little bird. A few months ago, she had done a well set that had a little well. And I loved the style of it and kind of doing this painterly effect of like stamping it with water reactive mediums like markers or something like that, and then kind of watercoloring in the image. So that was just kind of, you know, on the surface level of the artistic side of what we do. I was just like so excited and pumped for the stamp set to be able to do that. And I loved the idea of having all the little elements to go in the bird's mouth and just all like the creative artistic side. And I have a tendency to sometimes put that first before the devotional content, and it's not intentional. It just comes along with, I have such a passion for the artistic side, and so that it's just the fun part. And so sometimes I put that before the content. And so then as I sat down here to read the content, like I said, guys, I'm really gonna try not to cry. we're talking about seeking God's kingdom first above everything else, not having anxiety about things, not trying to do things on our own. And I'm trying to see, one of the reflection questions here is, compare and contrast prideful independence to the freedom of godly dependence. Have you experienced both? So we, our focus verse for this month is going to be Matthew 6:25-26. It says, therefore, I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or drink, or about your body, what you will wear. Is not life more than food, and the body more than clothes? Look at the birds of the air. They do not sow or reap or store away in barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not much more valuable than they? Oh, guys, I'm so sorry. We'll see if you guys actually see this video. I might edit it all out. There's just real world striving sometimes, and the anxiety of trying to provide and to minister to you guys and to share God's word in a way that's fun and exciting and creative, and trying to find that balance between the artistic side and the devotional side. And I know so many people say, you know, don't worry about it, Lindsay, just focus on the devotional. That's what's important, which yes, is so true for a lot of mature veteran Christians. But as a new Christian, sometimes it takes I don't know, creative ways to get them engaged and to teach them, and everybody learns in different ways. And so I have found this niche of this artistic way to do it. And so trying to find that balance between sharing product and giving you guys options and different, you know, devotional content from different companies and the artwork and how to use it. And I love what I do. I wouldn't change it for the world. I know God has put me in this place specifically. But it's been a lot. It's been a lot of trying to juggle family and health and these products and the devotional content and staying real with you guys while not getting too real, and just, you know, all that battle. And so as I sit here and just thank Danielle for the way God uses her to speak to us, and I know that there's so many of you may not be struggling with the exact same situation, but this battle between, you know, we do live in a world where we have to function. We have to pay our bills. We have to eat. We have to take care of our kids. We have, you know, whatever it is, but trying to find that balance between trusting in God and his provision and that he's going to take care of us and that he's going to guide us into the different things that he wants us doing versus the things that we want doing. I can't tell you how many times I've juggled with job situations. You know, am I doing this job because this is the job that God's given me to provide for my family, or am I doing this job because I want to be the one providing? Does that make sense? Like, me being independently doing things on my own. I am a control freak to the max. I am constantly trying to control things even when I don't even realize I'm trying to control it. And you know, my family has gone through a lot of struggles over the years with financially. I don't share that very often, but I mean, my family, we've been on welfare. We've had food stamps. We've been there. We've been at the low of the low when it comes to finances. And I was one of those people that was working full time and still just was not enough to provide for my family. And so tying my ministry in with a job like I have done here with my YouTube channel has been a difficult balance for me because there is a real world tangible money dollar sign attached to the views that I get on my videos. And so, yes, ultimately the reason I got into it was not the money. It was to share with you guys the word of God and to just reach out to people in a way that I couldn't reach out to physically around the world and in, you know, the middle of the night, middle of the day, wherever it might be. And I'm so thankful for that. But there is, you know, an aspect of seeing that the more content I put out, the more people that see it, the more money that then I can buy actual groceries for my family. And so trying to find that balance. So I'm just so thankful to have this reminder that it needs to all be for God. And there's a time to lean into him and to rely on him for his provision and what he's going to do for us in our lives. He may not want us to be living in a giant mansion with no money struggles and, you know, that kind of thing. I'm where I'm at because that's where he wants me to be at. And so I'm sorry, guys. I know that's a lot to throw into an unboxing video, but maybe it'll inspire and touch some of you guys that are struggling in the same way. So Danielle has several verse references for us. A lot of these verses that I am very familiar with because this is a thing I've struggled with for a long time. And so these are verses that I revisit very often, especially this one in Matthew. And so she's got some reflection questions for us to help us kind of interact with the devotional content that she has. Really, really great the way that she tackles this. I am even some word definition and study. So really good content this month, you guys. And then the fun part, of course, because that's the light, fluffy part that's going to keep me from crying through this entire video. So on the back side, we've got this fun feather print with these really pretty colors. I'm excited about the color palette for this month. So, and it's kind of nice. I know a lot of us are doing, you know, gratitude documented or 30 days of thankfulness. We're kind of focusing on those projects, which is great. And so I love that this kit is a short and easy one. So if you want to throw it into the mix in the month of November, or maybe you just want to pick it up and set it aside for another time. But I think a lot of us do face this anxiety as we head into the holiday time when we're trying to figure out how we're going to manage, you know, putting on a dinner for everybody at Thanksgiving or buying gifts for people at Christmas or, you know, all that. There's just this sense of anxiety during this time of year for a lot of people. And so I think that this is really going to speak to a lot of you. So you've got that. If you want to use the print on the backside, I would suggest either taking a picture of the devotional content or scanning it into your computer. And then that way you've got it on hand and you can go ahead and dive into cutting apart the backside and using this for tip-ins and tags and tabs and things like that on there. So there is a look at the devotional content from Danielle. Next up, this is something that's also very exciting, are enamel shapes. So sometimes she switches things up and instead of doing the bow clippies, she'll throw in some enamel shapes or some washi or something like that. So I actually audibly gasped out loud when I opened the package for this kit because these are amazing. She's got these like coppery ones, gold ones, and then this deep blue in hearts and dots and arrows, and I mean, just lots of fun shapes that you can get a lot of use out of. I love that these are neutrals, so they're not just specific to this kit, so you can mix and match these into other projects that you're using. I love the added kind of dimension and texture and things that you get from enamel shapes, and these can be pretty pricey when you're just buying them on their own, so I love that this is included, and you have tons of each one on this sheet. So you got enamel shapes, we've already covered the stamp set, of course it's got, you know, Seek Kingdom First, so you could do Seek His Kingdom First, His Kingdom First, so lots of different ways that you can mix and match those, and then the elements that you can use individually or kind of all stacked together to create a scene with that really pretty bird. I will be showing you a tutorial coming up very soon on how to do that watercolor bird the way that I was describing with the markers and things like that, so stay tuned for that. Next up, you've got the cardstock stickers. So you've got this sheet here that has the Word Fetti stickers. I like that these are a white base. Makes it really easy to mix and match, like I said, with other kits and things like that. So lots of words that kind of tie in with the devotional content. Of course, you've got your Creative Retreat wonky hearts. Love those. Some flowers, this really fun ampersand piece, and then lots of different birds. Feathers and a label there. So love that. Lots and lots of stuff packed into this month's kit. She utilized every little space on every, you know, the stamp set, the enamel shapes, and the cardstock stickers. She's got plenty of different elements in there. And then, yes, some tile alphas. Tile alphas are my favorite. She even stuck in a little extra sheet for me because she knows they're my favorite. So we've got three different colors, and you've got alphas and numbers, so I think it would be fun to mix and match the colors and kind of mix and match them within the word that you're spelling out, and then you get a little bit of each color in there. So there is a look at the Seek First Creative Faith Creative Retreat Faith Art Box for the month of November. Be sure to follow us over on the Creative Retreat YouTube channel because we will be sharing process videos throughout the month, and check out the description box for all the links that you guys can grab these goodies for yourself, and stay tuned. I will be working on this kit throughout the month and kind of sharing with you guys how I work through it. It's obviously going to be a very personal one for me, so I would encourage you to run on over, grab this one. Maybe you know somebody in your life that this is something they struggle with as well, and what a great way to gift them with something like this. And even if they're not Bible journalers, these products can be used in a just simple journal or notebook. It's not very intimidating for people who are new to that whole Bible journaling world, and the price point is great. It makes it very easy to just grab one and give it as a gift to somebody, and so what a great way to encourage somebody as we head into this hectic, crazy holiday season. So if you have any questions or comments, be sure to leave those down below. Check out the description box for all those links. Give this video a thumbs up if you're excited for this kit, and subscribe to my channel if you're not already subscribed. I promise I don't cry in every single video. That is a rarity. And until next time, thank you so much. Bye-bye.